Oh, hi, I'm the Heretic. So this has been a long time coming. A long time. But here it is. The answer to the 1,000 subscriber special. I asked for questions and you all delivered. And as promised, I answered. Let's jump into it.
Who will secure the borders? Who will build the wall?
Borders will all be people's privately owned property. The only reason someone in a voluntary society would be in there is because someone else wants to associate with them. Might want to do a video talking more about borders, actually.
As you and I are both practicing Catholics, we see that abortion is murder. How would abortion be prevented in an ANCAP society?
We simply refuse to associate with any medical facilities that make abortion available. At least then we can actually defund Planned Parenthood rather than vote and hope the priesthood of statism stops paying for a huge percentage of their operating budget.
What authority would parents have over their children in Capistan?
However much society wants them to have. They could consent on their behalf, for one thing, as children aren't mentally competent to sign contracts, but the parent-child relationship is very interesting, as the parents are in the same category of responsibility as a kidnapper is responsible for the well-being of their victim. The difference, of course, being that no NAP violations were committed at childbirth.
At what point would you become an adult?
When you get off your lazy ass and get a job.
How do people profit from building roads?
How do people profit from any construction project? It's being built because someone wants a road there and is willing to pay for it.
Some people might wonder what to know how accreditation of schools, colleges, and universities would work in our ANCAP society. For the sake of something to say when they bring it up, how would it work?
Schools will have reputations, much like how restaurants or tradespeople do on Angie's List or Yelp. Students who are their customers will leave reviews, and that will attract or repel people. Because the schools now are accountable to their customers rather than the state, they're actually incentivized to provide a quality education at a low price.
Crucify this straw man.
No problem.
In just a few years, he'll be in school, and Donald Trump wants to give his teacher a gun?
You trust the government union employees with your child's developing mind, but not with their lives? Then what the hell are you thinking, sending them to these places for 40 hours a week?
More students have been killed in school shootings in 2018 than U.S. troops in combat operations.
According to the Center for Disease Control, between 2005 and 2014, roughly 3,536 people died from drowning, so what's your point? Should we ban swimming?
We need common sense gun control, but that's not enough.
Make no mistake, there is no amount of freedom you can surrender to these totalitarian dick nuggets that will ever be enough.
There are 310 million guns in the US and millions of assault-style weapons.
Your facts are out of date, as I see the number 500 million guns being more common. Also note the deceptive use of language here. What's an assault-style weapon? A gun that's really scary looking and has all sorts of features that make it safer and easier to fire.
I'm Levi Tilleman. Washington needs more doers and innovators. That's why I'm running for US Congress. I'm calling on Congress to stop talking past each other and try something new.
If you were interested in trying something new, you'd be a voluntarist. Also, Washington has enough doers already. I'd prefer it if Congress people would just sit on their hands and leave us alone. Please, don't do anything.
Empower schools and teachers with non-lethal self-defense tools like this can of pepper spray. Pepper spray doesn't cost much, and it can be safely stored in a break glass in case of emergency cabinet. But it's powerful and won't accidentally kill a kid.
Pepper spray is only good at 20 feet for a 4-ounce can and is easily defended against by a shooter with sunglasses or is just closing their eyes. That's even assuming the teacher is skilled enough to hit the student directly in the eyes from 20 feet away. A shooter with a gun doesn't have to hit their target in the eyes and can do so from farther than 20 feet.
Trust me, this will stop anyone in their tracks.
It's incredibly painful, and now I just can't see anything.
Will it stop you from running for Congress? Then again, that won't be necessary as you lost your primary on June 26, 2018, so crisis averted. There's a 45-second bit of propaganda, so I'll just skip ahead.
Talk is cheap. Washington needs doers. It needs leaders to break through the partisan gridlock and build a better future. That starts with making our schools safe again.
No, the problem is there's too many doers who are all too interested in intruding into our businesses and our lives. A better future is one where the job you were trying to get didn't exist and you would leave us the hell alone. I think the reason you lost the primary, Levy, is that your platform of giving teachers pepper spray is really freaking dumb.
What are your thoughts on transhumanism?
Promising. Keep up the good work.
What do you use for your drawings?
Inkscape. At least until I can justify putting in the time to learn to draw for real.
What is the maximum number of questions a person can ask you in a Q&A?
I don't know.
What are your favorite music bands?
I don't really follow bands anymore.
Do you own any guns?
Sadly, no.
What is your thoughts on the Israel-Palestine conflict?
Still a better love story than Twilight.
Since you're a Roman Catholic, what do you think about the conspiracies about how the Roman Catholic Church is satanic or something like that?
The evidence isn't compelling, and it mostly has to do with the misinterpretation of certain symbols. The upside-down cross, for example, is the cross St. Peter asked to be crucified on as he felt himself unworthy to die the same way Jesus did.
How the frick do you only have 1,100 subs?
I know, right?
Atlas v. Aaron. Out of 1,000 matches, who wins? How many?
While Atlas has the advantage in experience, he only has 28 seconds to be what Aaron already is all the time. So I would say 750 Aaron. Of course, nobody's going to understand the context of this question.
If the NAP states that aggression can only be used in defense, then how does it allow property rights? Argument from a family member of mine.
Acquiring property is passive, so this assertion literally isn't possible. Your ownership of the computer you're watching this video on right now isn't aggressing against anyone.
Here's a question for you. Why did you decide to start YouTube?
To get fat, giant stacks of Illuminati hush money. Not going too well so far.
What is the meaning of life?
42.
I had a question given to me about monopolies. A big retail store came into a town. They competed with a small store. The big store lowered their prices of their product. The small store responded by going even lower. This is normal. Then the big store plummeted their prices. So much so the little store couldn't afford to keep their prices so low, they went out of business. The big store raised their prices back up to normal, holding monopoly over the area. The question asked to me was, what's to keep large companies such as Disney or Comcast from doing this to their competitors? They could get a monopoly without government intervention. This question to me has been bugging me for a while.
It's a question of scale. Say Business A makes $100 million a year, and Business B makes $100,000. If they both cut their prices by the same rate, then the situation presented in conventional thinking would be that Business A's greater resources would allow them to withstand that loss of revenue, right? Well, let's do some dirty math. If they reduce their prices by 10%, then Company B would lose $10,000 in revenue, whereas Company A loses $10 million. To do what exactly? To gain the market share of Company B and get an extra $100,000 where it will take 100 years just to break even? The facts are that predatory pricing on the part of large businesses makes no sense and is only possible today because government subsidizes large corporations like Comcast and Disney, insulating them from the consequences of their actions.
What are your honest opinions on Richard Spencer, Mike Enoch, etc., etc., and the alt-right in general?
Totalitarian imbeciles who are no different than the SJWs they claim to be against.
When and how did you first learn the real truth about what the government does to us? Where did you get the idea to make a YouTube channel?
I couldn't give you a when, but what first introduced me to these ideas is a little-known video called The State Is Not Great, How the Government Poisons Everything. It's a fantastic video, and I'll link it in the description.
I am a relatively new subscriber and I'm curious about your thoughts on feminism and SJWs.
Totalitarian imbeciles who are no different than the alt-right they claim to be against.
Now question, what's your favorite kind of lizard? I personally love the Komodo dragon.
Armadillo girdled lizard. I mean, just look at the thing, it's adorable.
Sweet. Now here's a question. How do I start to change the minds of my very, very indoctrinated state-worshipping socialist friends? They are good people, just so damn brainwashed. What makes this worse is they are far more intelligent and articulate than I, but they don't realize the state doesn't need to exist. They also don't realize that the state uses science to control them. They just believe whatever the mainstream media tells them. They would be such a powerhouse in the fall of government if they could just think for themselves.
It's a gradual process, but try to introduce these ideas in ways they might understand or even agree with. Like, look up information on the repression of labor by the state, or explain how unnecessary regulations or licensing prevents the construction of workers' co-ops. You can frame anarchist ideas in ways that socialists can understand, and I think that's the best way to go. Even if they don't go capitalist, if they can at least go individualist in some way, we'll be okay.
My only question is, how old are you? You're a brilliant mind, and if you ever ran for office, I should vote for you.
No, 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 no. Don't vote for me or anyone else. I mean, I'm flattered you think that of me, but voting is a distraction from the real work we can do in the private sector to spread these ideas about and innovate the state out of existence.
Do you think the monikers of country, state, or nation can apply to an anarchist society, or are they permanently tied to lands ruled by government institutions?
Country, nation, possibly. State, of course not.
On anarcho-capitalist court systems, would you just blacklist a murderer, or would harsher punishment be applied?
He'd be blacklisted from society completely unless he's continuously providing a huge amount of value to the victim's families or next of kin. But they will be treading on thin ice for the rest of their life.
Could an anarchic society exist in a pre-industrial era?
Absolutely. Trade routes existed for tens of thousands of years before the first state. So it's not a question of could.
Monopolies can still be formed without lobbying to the government, and a corporation with that much power could easily use covert malpractice. How could this be handled?
The only ways monopolies could form is either technological innovation, such as Apple having their temporary monopoly on the smartphone market, but as I alluded to, those are extremely temporary, or they could be so good and so successful at what they do consistently that the market rewards a company with a huge market share. Such a natural monopoly is equally fragile, and the moment, the very instant they stop catering to their customers' needs and engage in shady shenanigans, they're done, as they're no longer acting in their customers' best interests.
How much money could a company make if a company could make money?
Depends how much their customers want them to.
Is it a violation of the NAP to take aggressive action to prevent another violation of the NAP?
I need some context before I could answer that.
Companies will do shady stuff and they will most likely get away with it. Do you think an institution will be formed to combat this?
Competitors looking to gain an advantage on their competition will leak to the media all the shady stuff their competition is into, and this will be far more effective than any government bureaucracy you could possibly come up with.
If someone else lives in the same vicinity as you, isn't it possible for it to benefit for defensive services you and your other neighbors paid for?
Yes, and that's a good thing, because it lowers crime.
Do you like video games, and if so, what kind?
I like a lot of games, actually. FPS, strategy games, puzzle games, and I have a soft spot for platformers.
How do you address the idea of technocracy?
Totalitarian idiocy, and literally fascism.
Are you still accepting scripts for your vids? I got one in my head, and it would be an interesting radical solution of school shootings.
No, but you can still talk to me about it on Twitter.
What do you think of Salazzle?
Good special attacking potential, especially with that killer speed and amazing offensive typing. Access to Nasty Plot makes her a fantastic special sweeper if you can get the setup. However, low defensive stats and vulnerability to a lot of extremely common attacking types, including a double weakness to the ubiquitous Earthquake, limit Salazzle's staying power and utility. Sure, this can be mitigated with her huge number of type resistances and the air balloon, but she lacks the staying power to really be a powerful sweeper. Maybe if she were tankier, she'd be a threat, but right now she needs a team comp to be built around making her useful with U-turn or Volt Switch. Overall, she's a decent, maybe a good revenge killer, but there's so many better special sweepers like Volcarona or Gengar. I'd only consider her for my team if I absolutely need to get toxic onto an opposing steel type.
What are your thoughts on anarcho-egoism?
Egoism rejects objectivity in ethics and morals, arguing that such things are purely subjective preferences. Unfortunately, this puts the questions of murder, theft, and rape on the same level of importance as the question of Pepsi versus Coke. Thus, to the egoist, statism cannot be any more or less valid than anarchism, subject to the atomized and fickle whims of individual preference. I mean, yes, egoists can be anarchists, but they don't have any principled basis for it. In fact, they reject the very idea of principles altogether.
How would you respond to this argument for UHC? There are people who can't afford healthcare, not because they are bad with money, but because they were hurt while just starting off in life and don't have much at all. We've got to do something for those people.
Why must you use extortion against me to pay for it? Do you not think you could convince me otherwise to give charity for this guy?
If you control the world, how come you even make these videos?
Well, lizards control the world, I don't. And I don't want to. All I want is a voluntary society and at least 8 figures of Illuminati hush money.
Why did you pick a lizard as your avatar?
Because I can.
If you were to go to hell, what do you think your punishment would be?
I would have my head twisted all the way back and be forced to walk backwards for all eternity. It'd suck.
Do you believe that the 21st century will really be an Asian one, as many have said? With the rapid growth of India and China, they're both expected to surpass the USA by 2050. Chinese brands like, I don't know how to pronounce that, are already top players in the smartphone market, and I don't know how to pronounce that either, is expected to become the 5th largest with time.
I don't know about India, but China's economy is an even bigger house of cards than the US's. I couldn't say what'll happen, but I'd be skeptical.
If in an ANCAP society, private security can't lock you up like an animal, quote from Mr. Dapperton, then what happens after private security has apprehended you?
They'd investigate you to see if you're guilty of the crime accused. Then, if a court agrees, you'll be asked to pay the victim or victim's next of kin or be blacklisted from society.
Congrats. Thoughts on Ayn Rand?
Almost an anarchist. Couldn't quite make the leap.
Why, you know, update your avatar.
I did. And that's all of them. Thank you so much for your patience and for helping this channel grow from nothing into ascendancy in the time it has. We've still got a way to go, but I think we're getting closer to liberating the minds of the acolytes of the religion of statism. Let's see if we can't get to 2,000 subscribers. I know we can do it. Thank you again to all my subscribers and all my Patreon supporters. You guys are awesome. Starting September, I will be doing a monthly Q&A for patrons. A single dollar in support is all that's needed to ask a question. Speaking of, questions, comments, critique? What do you think? How soon until we reach 2,000 subscribers? Support me through Patreon and Ko-Fi. Like, share, and subscribe to become a heretic today.